Hello friends and students, I welcome you all for this initiative on learning SolidWorks, a solid modeling software in 21 days. From today, you all know that we will be in the lockdown period till April 14th. Today is day 1. From today onwards, I will be teaching this SolidWorks solid modeling software, how you can use this software to develop and make the solid models. From the solid models, how you can get the drawings and assemblies also. Every day I will be spending somewhere between 15 to half an hour exclusively for this particular subject. Now let's go to subject. SolidWorks is a mechanical design automation software. It is a feature based parametric solid modeling design tool. You can create fully associative 3D models with or without constraints while utilizing automatic or user defined relations to capture design intent. The basic concepts of the software, the 3D design. Each design project begins with a 3D model from which drawings can be produced. From the start, SolidWorks is aimed at modeling in 3 dimensions. So what you are going to see is not a 2 dimensional one, you will be seeing the 3 dimensional solid creation in these sessions. Today being the first day, a first session, I will be telling you about how to open the software right from the scratch and what are all the contents and features and the ingredients that is available in this particular software. So slowly you will be learning each and every aspect of the software in stages in the following days. Now let us see, it is fully associative parts. Parts is nothing but a solid object. A cylinder, a cube is a solid part. A liter can be called as a sheet metal, or a 1 liter or a 15 liter tin is a sheet metal, car body is a sheet metal. So part means a solid object. Assembly, if you assemble more than 2 parts, then it becomes assembly. I can take for example the bolt and nut. Bolt is a part, nut is a part. If you fit both, then it becomes assembly. And drawing, you can make parts and assemblies in solid modeling software, but how you convey the message that you intend to make it to the shop floor worker, it is possible only through drawings. So that is why the drawing also important when it comes to making a product. It is fully associative. I will explain you what is meant by the fully associative feature in the SolidWorks later. A fully completed solid model consists of parts, assemblies and drawings. As I said earlier, usually you begin with a sketch. A sketch is nothing but a 2-dimensional entity. Take for example, if you want to make a cylinder, cylinder has got 2 parameters. One is the base dia and the height. The base is nothing but a circle, which is a 2-dimensional entity. So the 2-dimensional entity here is called a sketch. So you have to, if you want to make any solid model, you have to start from the sketch, start from the 2-dimensional entity only. So with a sketch, create a base feature and then add more and more features to create a required solid object. The design of a model part can be changed at any time. This is called parametric modeling, by editing or recording the features which makes it up. It is a parametric solid modeling software. As I said earlier, the meaning for the parametric modeling software is you can change the values of the entities any time and any number of times. That is the beauty of this particular software. If you take AutoCAD software, take for example, you have drawn a rectangle of size 60 by 30. After some time you will come to know it is not 30 by 60, it is 50 by 70. So you have to erase it, then you have to recreate the rectangle afresh in AutoCAD. Whereas in SolidWorks, which is a parametric modeling software, you can change the values. All the values are not static values, it is controlled, they are controlled by variables. You can keep on changing the values. At one point of time the rectangle size can be 60 by 30, at some time you can change it to 50 by 70 or 80 by 90, as you wish. Okay, now let me minimize this one. I'll open the SolidWorks software. This is the SolidWorks software 2016. I installed it in my system. I'm using it for the academic purposes. For the past decade, I developed many parts and products using this software. So this is how it looks. Now go to File, open a new file. When you click New, you will get three options. They are Part, Assembly and Drawing. I already told you earlier that this is, if you click this one, you are about to create a solid model. You can use this only if you make more than two parts. Okay, so we will be seeing this in the later sessions, maybe after 10 days. The drawing part also is possible only after making a part. So creation of part is a first priority now. Okay, let me click and press OK. Now this is how your screen will appear. So now for your convenience, this is the toolbar for sketch. As per my convention, I will be keeping the sketch toolbar in the right hand side. This is about the features, I will tell you later, and some of the other toolbars that you require for creating the solid models. Okay, now let it be the background be the plain white. Okay, so this is the design tree. So whatever activities that you do here, it will appear here actually, right? You can roll back also at some time. Now let us say about our first task. Lesson 1, to create a cylinder of base diameter 60 mm and height 90 mm. So this is our first lesson. So today we will be seeing one and only about how to make a solid model, a cylinder of base diameter 60 mm and height 90 mm. Okay, now you have to start from drawing the base circle whose diameter is 60 mm, which is nothing but a sketch in this case. Now I'll be slowly adding some more terminals that we'll be using in this particular software. Okay, terminologies, the first one is sketch. The sketch is a two-dimensional entity. Okay, so to draw a cylinder, you have to draw a circle first, which is nothing but a two-dimensional entity. Okay, then feature is a primitive three-dimensional entity. A feature is nothing but a primitive three-dimensional entity. A cylinder is a primitive entity. A cone is a primitive three-dimensional entity. A square prism, a cube, a rectangular pyramid, they are all coming under primitive three-dimensional entity. Let us take a part. Again, it is also a 3D entity, but having more features. Okay, so take for example a hexagonal prism. The best example for the hexagonal prism is a pencil. A fresh pencil, a new pencil, can be considered as a hexagonal prism. If you sharpen it, then the tip portion alone will become a cone. So, a new pencil, I can call it a feature. Once you sharpened it, it becomes a part. How? If you segmentize, cone is one segment, that is one primitive three-dimensional entity, then the remaining portion is a hexagonal prism. So, it becomes a part now. Again, I repeat, a new pencil is a simple primitive three-dimensional entity, I can call it as a feature. If you sharpened it, then the tip becomes a cone, the rest is a hexagonal prism. So, it is no longer a feature now, it becomes a part, because having more features, cone is one feature and the hexagonal prism is another feature. So, like that, you can make any part combining many features, and if you combine many parts, you can make assembly. Okay, so this is the concept. Now let us take this problem. It is to create a cylinder of base diameter 60 mm and height 90 mm. Okay, now for this you have to draw the circle first, the sketch of diameter 60 mm. You can draw the sketch either by clicking this front plane, or by clicking the top plane, or by clicking the right plane. Okay, meaning take your own room, you are standing in a room. Okay, the floor on which you are standing, you can map it as a top plane. The floor, the ground floor of the room is a top plane. You are viewing one wall in front of you, that I call it a front plane. The side plane, either the right side or the left side, okay, is called the right plane here. So, drawing a circle of diameter is 60, which is nothing but a sketch now, is the first task that we supposed to do. Okay, for that, it is something like, take a pen, you can draw a circle either on your ground plane, the base floor, or in the front wall, or in the right side or the left side of the wall. So you can choose any one of these three plates, any one of these three plates, the choice is yours. Okay, all are correct. In my case, let me choose the top plane. So I clicked this top plane, then look at carefully, this is the button for initiating drawing the circle, which is nothing but the sketch here. Okay, again I repeat, it's a new file, click the top plane, click the sketch. Now you see, the moment I clicked this one, okay, now you will get these two symbols. If you get these two symbols, it is nothing but you are inside the sketch, you are inside the, it is something like you put your pencil or pen onto the top plane or onto the floor. Okay, you are about to draw or you are about to scribble something on the floor, on this top plane. Okay, after drawing the circle, if you press this one, you will be exiting from the sketch, then you are ready for drawing the feature. Again I repeat, the first lesson here is, it is to draw a cylinder of base diameter 60 mm and height 90 mm. For that, the first step is to draw a sketch. The sketch is nothing but a circle of diameter 60 mm. Okay, now we are in, I am inside the sketch. Now this is the command button available here to draw a circle. Now I will be clicking this one. The dialog box will appear here. Actually, you are, there are two ways of drawing the circle: center and radius or diameter, and 3-point circle. By default, this is the convenient one for all of us. The one is the center point, the two is the radius or the diameter. Okay, so I'll be just clicking somewhere on the screen, then I'll be drawing. Okay, so this is over. I press escape. Okay, my circle is drawn. Then the, what is the diameter of the circle? The diameter of the circle is 60. So I have to give the dimension for it. So this is the button for dimensioning. So I clicked this one, then I just type 60. Okay, so your circle is escaped them. Escape means you are escaping from the dimensioning. Okay, so your circle is drawn. Then we have put the dimension for this circle. Now exit from the sketch. Now the sketch is over. Then we are ready for drawing the cylinder, drawing the feature. So sketch is over. Now we are drawing the feature. Now it is a initial three-dimensional entity. Okay, exit from the sketch. Okay, a sketch is drawn. Now you see, in the design tree, a new thing has been added here called a sketch one. The minus symbol is there. I'll tell you what it indicates later, about this minus symbol later. Now sketch is over. Now we are about to complete the feature or the part. Of course, in this particular exercise, cylinder is the part. It has only one feature. Okay, now select this one. This is the command bar available for the feature. I normally keep this one on the left hand side. Okay, you can arrange all these command buttons according to your choice, actually, according to your convenience. Okay, now this has been selected. Then you see, I can use the extruded bars, revolve, sweep. There are many portions that, but first exercise is to draw a cylinder. For that, the command is extruded bars or base. Just press this one. Sorry, after clicking this, just press this one. The boss extrude dialog box will appear. Okay, there are many options available. I will explain these things in the later stage. Okay, now First, let us complete this exercise number 1, a cylinder of diameter 60 and height is 90. Here, by default, the value 10 mm, the height is set as 10 mm. Instead of 10, you just type 90, then press OK. Now you see, you can use the letter F to fit the entire entity into this screen. Okay, so a cylinder is drawn. Okay, now I will tell you some of the mouse actions. By pressing and holding the mid button of your mouse, you can dynamically rotate the object. Then using this, you can see the front view, you can see the side view, you can see the top view, you can see the isometric view. Then using this, you can see the line, the hidden lines removed. You can see the object as line entities. Then hidden lines visible. Now hidden line is visible here. All lines visible. So this is the shaded image. Okay. So this is how you can this one. You can view the different. You can see the different views of your model. So pressing and holding the mid button of your mouse, you can, if you move it, you can dynamically rotate the object. Then this is isometric view, right? Pressing the shift button in the keyboard and pressing and holding the mid button, and if you move it, you can zoom in and zoom out. So now I zoomed in. Okay, as I said earlier, if I press F button in the keyboard, then the object is fit to screen. Okay, it is zoom out and everything will be fit into the screen. So this is how you can use all the controls and commands of the SOLIDWORKS software. So now we have completed the first exercise in this particular session. So let me type first exercise is over. Okay. Let us go in depth to how to define and how to perfectly complete this part. You know, of course, we have completed the task. Okay. So mission is accomplished, but still there is more refined way of doing it. For that, let me say constraining or defining a sketch. Defining or constraining a sketch. What is this defining and constraining a sketch? Of course, we have completed the problem, you know. Okay, even though you have completed the problem, now you see, if you see the sketch, if I double click this button, you are inside the sketch. Now you see, when I move the mouse, you can see the dynamic location of the cursor. And there is another indication called underdefined, and there is another indicator that shows I am following millimeter, gram, second. So you can choose either meter, kilogram, second, or centimeter, gram, second. The millimeter is default because in engineering everything we draw, we mention, we give the dimensions only in millimeters only. Inch, pound, second also you can choose, but the default is mm, gs. Okay, even you have to set your system to mm, gs only. That will be convenient. You see, I am inside the sketch now. It says it is underdefined, meaning the answer is right, but still it is underdefined. This is coming under the topic called the defining or constraining a sketch. How to define it? To define it, there are two ways. They are defining by dimension, defining by relations. Okay, defining by dimension, defining by relations. Okay, this minus symbol indicates it is underdefined. Here in SolidWorks, this indication will be there in three locations. Here you can see the sketch is underdefined. In the design tree, if you have minus symbol, if it has minus symbol, that is underdefined. Then see the color of this sketch. The sketch is a circle. The color of the sketch is blue actually now. So in three locations, you can get the details about whether your sketch or the part or the feature is fully defined, underdefined, or overdefined or not. So here one place, here the other place, third is the color of the sketch. Now let me tell you how to define the sketch using dimension. Okay, now for that I will be using the dimension. This is the origin. From the origin, with respect to, there should be a relation between this origin and the center of the circle. Since it is not there, it tells that it is underdefined. Okay, if we define it, then it becomes fully defined. So let me say it is 40 mm away from the horizontal, and now if again one more thing, if you notice, it's a smart dimension. If you go this way, it automatically detects by itself that you are about to give the vertical dimensioning. If you go this way, it automatically detects, the software automatically detects that you will be drawing the horizontal dimensioning. This is the aligned dimension. Okay, now I'm horizontal dimensioning already over, I'm giving the vertical dimension. So it is vertically, it is 20 mm away, vertically 20 mm above, horizontally 40 mm to the right. Now you see the color of the sketch, it becomes black. You see what it indicates, it is fully defined. Now you are not having the symbol, minus symbol. That means the sketch is fully defined. The sketch is fully defined. Okay, so this is how you can define or you can constrain the sketch and the features. Once again, I double click this one. Okay, the moment I delete any one of these, then it becomes, the color of the sketch becomes blue. It tells underdefined. It shows minus symbol. Okay, it is acceptable. Your sketch and feature can be either underdefined or fully defined. Okay, it should not be overdefined. Okay, even the software won't allow you to move further if the sketch is overdefined. Please mind it. Okay, so there are three possibilities: underdefined, fully defined, overdefined. So this is acceptable. This is really good. This is not acceptable. This is not acceptable. Okay? So we have seen underdefined and overdefined using dimension. We will see how to use the relations for defining the sketch. So now, what is relation first of all? That dimension we know. What is relation? He is my uncle, she is my aunt. These are the relations. The same way, this person is to my left, that girl is to my right, the pillar is in front of me or behind me. So these are the relations actually, right? So in mechanical terms, collinear, parallel, perpendicular, midpoint, these are the relations. Okay, let me start using a relation to fully define it. One horizontal, that is one dimension, and one relation, through that I can define it fully. So for that I have to select this center, the origin, and the center of the circle. To select two entities, you have to press and hold the control key. So press and hold the control key, click the origin point, click the center point of the circle. If you press and hold this control key, then only you can select these two. Otherwise, you can select only one. By clicking this, you will be without pressing the alter key. Now I will show you. Now this is selected. I have not pressed this control key. Now this origin deselected and this is selected. So press and hold control key. So then you can go for multiple selection. So after selecting these two, the property dialog box will automatically pop up here. So I just have to ensure and select this relation. These two are horizontal. Okay. Now undo it. Now it is blue in color. The moment I press this one, now you see this blue in color, it is underdefined. I have just pressed the relation, it becomes black, it tells fully defined. So in this case, I used one dimension and one relation. So it becomes fully defined, right? Okay. Now, let me undo it, control Z. Let me delete both the horizontal and vertical dimension. Let me use only one relation to fully define it. I select both the origin and the center of the circle. I am clicking the relation called the coincident. The moment I clicked, then both will be coincident. The color of this sketch is black. It says it is fully defined. So the defining or constraining a sketch, if you want to be a good CAD design engineer, better whenever you are drawing a sketch, to the maximum possible extent constrain or define the sketch. That is always better. Okay, so underdefined is okay, but fully defined means you are excellent. Okay, defining or constraining by two ways: defining using dimension, defining or constraining using relations. With my experience, I suggest you go for more relations. Okay, if it is not possible, you go for dimension. Wherever is possible, you use the relations. If it is not possible, then you go for dimension. Okay, that is the best way. Okay, based on my experience. Now we have seen exit from the sketch. Now you see there is no minus symbol. Once again I double click this one. Whenever I double click this sketch one, I will get into the sketch. It is fully defined. Okay, we'll see how to make over constraint. Again I choose this one. this one is not allowing actually automatically. Okay, in some time we will see about the over constraint, not here now, right? So this is this is almost we have almost seen the solution for the first exercise to create a cylinder of diameter 60 and height 90. Okay, now I will add one more thing in this particular session to use equation. Okay, this equation is a very good tool that should be used, in my view, in my experience, in all the diagrams, all the part modeling, wherever is possible. The best example for this is in machine drawing, probably you would have studied about while drawing the flange coupling. The flange coupling has got many parts and features, okay, but all the dimensions are related to the shaft diameter D. If the shaft diameter D, shaft diameter is D, then the flange diameter is 2D. The pitch circle diameter is 1.5D. Hub diameter is 0.75D. So something, everything is related to the diameter of the shaft. So the idea is, suppose if the diameter, if you want to change, all the other values should be proportionally changed. So it is possible only if you use equation. Okay. So I'll tell you how to use the equation here. After that, I'll wind up the session. Okay. Now if I double click this one, but before equation, let me tell you about one more thing: the parametric modeling software. All these things are controlled by variables. You know, you see, the moment I move this one, you see D1 at sketch 1 is the variable that controls the value, the diameter of the circle. This 90 is controlled by the variable D1 at boss extrude 1. So you see, what is the relationship between these two? It is 1.5, the height is 1.5 times of the diameter of the circle. Okay, so if it is 60, it is 90. If it is 50, it should be 75. But it is not I haven't introduced an equation. I can independently alter the values. Now instead of 60, if I put 50, then you rebuild it. This is the button for rebuilding, Control B or rebuild button. Now it is resized. Now you see, so this is the feature. That is why this software is called a parametric modeling software. You can double click, you can change the value, you can change the value. Okay, rebuild it. Now you see, previously it was 60, 90, now it is 50, 150. Okay, let me go back. 60, 90. Okay, rebuild. This is the button for rebuilding, or Control B, fit to scale. Now double click this one. Now I teach you how to use the equation. Even in many training centers, they won't teach all these things, how to use equations and how to use the relations, how to constrain it, or how to define the sketches and all. Okay, inside in tools it is available. In tools, you see, you have this equation menu. Click this equation menu, add equation. After clicking here, click this one, equal to this one into star is nothing but into 1.5 times. So the height of this one is 1.5 times of the diameter. I press OK. Rebuild it. Then if you double click this one, you see a sigma symbol is added in the height value. That means you cannot change the value, this one. If you change here, this will be changed automatically with the help of equation. Now previously I showed you, when I change this 160 to 50, it remained as 90. Now let me change this 60 from 60 to 50, rebuild it. I did not change the height, but I change only this one, but you see the change in the height. This has been changed automatically. How? It is changed only because of the equation. Now if you double click this one, you cannot input the value. Of course you can change the equation. Now let me show you. Now instead of 1.5 times, let me put 2 times. If it is 50, that should be 100. Now you see, suppose if it is 1:2, use the equation. If you change this one, this will be changed automatically. That is the use and power of the equation. So that is why I said earlier, whenever it is possible, try to use equation. Thereby you can increase your speed and the productivity more quickly. So for this today's session, I hope you have understood about the basic concepts of the SolidWorks. The first exercise, how to draw a cylinder. The terminology is sketch, feature, part. Of course, part is not applicable in this particular, for this particular exercise. The defining and constraining a sketch two ways, by dimensioning and by relations, underdefined, fully defined, overdefined, how to use equations. Okay, so thank you so much. Maybe in the tomorrow session I'll be telling you more about how to draw more and more, how to solve more and more problems. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.